Drugs and Cosmetics Act 1940 and Rules 1945. The previous video of this chapter was on some important definitions from Drugs and Cosmetics Act. In this video also, the remaining definitions will be covered. The learning outcome of this video is the student will be able to define the different terms related to the Act. Misbranded drug. A drug shall be deemed to be misbranded if it is so colored, coated, powdered, or polished that damage is concealed, or if it is made to appear of better or greater therapeutic value than it really is. Means hiding the true nature of the drug by coloring, coating, powdering, or polishing to show it of greater therapeutic value. If it is not labeled in the prescribed manner, there are some general requirements of labeling. If drug is not labeled according to these guidelines, it may be called as misbranded drug. Or if its label or container or anything accompanying the drug bears any statement, design or device which makes any false claim for the drug or which is false or misleading any particular. Means a false statement or a false claim about the drug is made, such drug is also called as a misbranded drug. Adulterated drug. A drug shall be deemed to be adulterated if it consists in whole or in part of any filthy, putrid or decomposed substance. Filthy means dirty and putrid means having bad smell, just like smell of rotten flesh. Or if it has been prepared, packed or stored under insanitary conditions, whereby it may have been contaminated with filth or whereby it may have been rendered injurious to health, or if its container is composed in whole or in part of any poisonous or deleterious substance which may render the content injurious to health, or if it bears or contains for purpose of coloring only a color other than the one which is prescribed, or if it contains any harmful or toxic substance which may render it injurious to health, or if any substance has been mixed therewith so as to reduce its quality or strength. Spurious drug. A drug shall be deemed to be spurious if it is imported or manufactured in relation to manufacture, sale and distribution of drugs under a name which belongs to another drug, or if it is an imitation of or is a substitute for another drug or resembles another drug in a manner likely to deceive or bear upon it or upon its label or container the name of another drug. Means the drug is copy of another drug or looks like another drug. If the label or container bears the name of an individual or company purporting to be the manufacturer of the drug, which individual or company is fictitious or does not exist. Means the label or container of drug is containing a name of manufacturer, but in reality such a manufacturer does not exist. Or if it has been substituted wholly or in part by another drug or substance. Or if it purports to be the product of a manufacturer of whom it is not truly a product. This means the label is showing name of a manufacturer, such a manufacturer is in existence, but the drug is not product of such a manufacturer. New drug. A new substance of chemical, biological or biotechnological origin in bulk or prepared dosage form used for prevention, diagnosis or treatment of disease in man or animal, which except during local clinical trials has not been used in the country to any significant extent, and which except during local clinical trials has been recognized in the country as effective and safe for proposed claims. Here we can say that a new drug may be of chemical, biological or biotechnological origin. It is used for prevention, diagnosis or treatment of diseases in man or animal. It is used only in clinical trials and it is safe and effective. Second part of this definition is a drug already approved by the licensing authority for certain claims, which is now proposed to be marketed with modified or new claims, namely indications, dosage, dosage forms, and route of administration. This means a drug was already available in the market with certain indications, dosage, dosage form, etc. But now the same drug is again coming in market with new claims, maybe change in indications or change in dosage or change in dosage form or route of administration. Third of the part of the definition is a fixed dose combination of two or more drugs individually approved earlier for certain claims, which are now proposed to be combined for the first time in a ratio, or if the ratio of ingredients in the already marketed combination is proposed to be changed with certain claims, that is indications, dosage form, dosage and route of administration. Two or more drugs were already approved and available in market individually, but now their combination is coming in market for the first time with new claims. Misbranded cosmetic. A cosmetic shall be deemed to be misbranded if it contains a color which is not prescribed, or if it is not labeled in the prescribed manner, or if the label or container or anything accompanying the cosmetic bears any statement which is false or misleading in any particular. Spurious cosmetics. A cosmetic shall be deemed to be spurious if it is imported or manufactured under name which belongs to another cosmetic, or if it is an imitation of or a substitute for another cosmetic or resembles another in a manner likely to deceive or bear upon it or its label the name of another cosmetic, unless it is plainly and conspicuously marked so as to reveal its true character and its lack of identity with such other cosmetic, or if the label or container bears the name of an individual or a company purporting to be the manufacturer of the cosmetic, which individual or company is fictitious or does not exist, or if it purports to be the product of a manufacturer of whom it is not truly a product. Formative assessment. Question number 1. If a drug contains toxic substances making it injurious to health, it is called as. Options are misbranded drug, adulterated drug, spurious drug and new drug. Question number 2. A drug purporting to be the product of a manufacturer of whom it is not truly a product is misbranded drug, adulterated drug, spurious drug or a new drug. Pause the video for some time and give answers of these two questions. The answers are, for the first question, the correct option is adulterated drug. If a drug contains toxic substances making it injurious to health, it is called as a adulterated drug. Second question, a drug purporting to be the product of a manufacturer of whom it is not truly a product is spurious drug. Option C. Next definition, drugstore, chemist and druggist and pharmacy. Drugstore, licensed premises for sale of drugs which do not require the services of a qualified person. Chemist and druggist, licensed premises for the sale of drugs which require the services of a qualified person but where the drugs are not compounded against prescription. Pharmacy, licensed premises for the sale of drugs which require the services of a qualified person and where the drugs are compounded against prescription. Qualified person, he is a person who holds a diploma or degree in pharmacy or pharmaceutical chemistry or is a registered pharmacist according to Pharmacy Act 1948 or has minimum 4 years experience of dispensing and has been approved by licensing authority as a qualified person on or before 31st December 1969. Means a person holding degree or diploma in pharmacy or if he is a registered pharmacist or if he have 4 years experience of dispensing and is declared by licensing authority, he may be called as a qualified person. Homeopathic medicines. It includes any drug recorded in homeopathic provings or the drugs whose therapeutic efficacy has been established through long clinical experience as recorded in authoritative homeopathic literature and which are prepared according to the techniques of homeopathic pharmacy. It also includes combination of ingredients of such homeopathic medicines but does not include medicines given by parenteral route. These drugs are prepared according to homeopathic techniques and which are therapeutically effective, but parenteral drugs are not included in homeopathic medicines. Registered medical practitioner. It means a person holding a qualification granted by an authority specified in Section 3 of the Indian Medical Degrees Act 1916 or specified in the schedule to the Indian Medical Council Act 1956. A qualification for registered medical practitioner is specified in Section 3 of the Indian Medical Degree Act and scheduled to Indian Medical Council Act. Any person holding this qualification is known as registered medical practitioner. Or registered or eligible for registration in a medical register of the state meant for registration of persons practicing the modern scientific system of medicine excluding the homeopathic system of medicine. That person whose name is entered in the medical register of state or he is eligible for entering his name in medical register is also called as registered medical practitioner. Registered in a medical register other than a register for the registration of homeopathic practitioners of a state who, although not falling within subclause 1 or subclause 2, is declared by a general or special order made by the state government in this behalf as a person practicing the modern scientific system of medicine for the purpose of this act. Even if the person is not falling in above point 1 and 2, if he may be declared by state government as a person practicing the modern scientific system of medicine. or registered or eligible for registration in the Register of Dentist for a state under the Dentist Act 1948 or who is engaged in the practice of veterinary medicine and who possesses qualifications approved by the state government. Formative assessment. Again, here are the two multiple choice questions. Question number one, license premise for the sale of drugs requiring the services of a qualified person is called as options, drugstore, chemist and druggist, and pharmacy. Question number two, qualified person is options, person holding the degree or diploma in pharmacy, person having 4 years experience of dispensing, a registered pharmacist, and all the above. Pause the video for some time and try to give answers of these two questions. The answers are, for question number 1, license premise for sale of drug requiring the service of a qualified person is called as pharmacy, option C. And question number 2, qualified person is options is D, all the above, means person holding degree or diploma in pharmacy, also person having 4 years experience of dispensing and a registered pharmacist. So in this video we have covered the definitions of drugstore, chemist, druggist and pharmacy, qualified person, homeopathic medicine, registered medical practitioner, etc.